Hello everyone, it's me Sato again from Low Level Cosplay, and today I'm gonna show you how I made this Heisenberg's hammer from Resident Evil 8 Village. So let's go. First of all, I started with the rough pattern, so I know roughly about the size I want to make this hammer. And I already made the handle out of wood because this goes later in the hammer itself and it needs to be stable enough. So I already cut out 4 pieces and now it's time to glue them together to make the main body for the hammer. For the glue I just use normal contact cement. So now that the 4 pieces are glued together, it needs a top and a bottom. Here you can see me gluing the top on the piece. Yeah, I made a mistake because this body is a little bit too big, but I will later cut it a bit smaller and glue it back together. So this is a bottom piece and it just has a slot in for the handle itself, and I also glued a 2 cm on the inside for more stability. These 3 pieces are the front of the motor block and they will be glued on the top of the box. They are made out of 2 circles and it's weirdly shaped. I don't really know what it's called, but yeah, you can see what it is. These are just 2 yarn holders and I will cut off the ends and use them as some rivets or something like this on this engine block. Here I just drew a few lines on this engine block and score them with an insector blade and use the heat gun to open them up. So this weirdly piece goes on the side of the engine block. It will be a little bit modified later and I can show you here which piece will be cut out. So this is a piece so far. I sadly lost a little bit of footage here, but yeah, I rest the piece in the inside a little bit as you can see, and the white piece is just the top of a ramen bottle. These small pieces are just made up, they are weirdly shaped but just straight lines, so it's easy to make this. And the metal part in the middle is just from a pipe I had lying around, and yeah, it's just glued in place. So I cut these pieces out of 2 cm EVA, and these pieces just for decoration. It has a cutscene because I was almost out of material. And now I'm gluing them together. So this is what it looks like so far, and the side will be dremeled clean later. Additionally, I made these small pieces that will be glued on for more details, and in total there are 8 of them. So now that this is done, it will be glued on top of the main piece, and the white caps are just Miller milk caps from bottles, and I use the 2 offcuts from the yarn holder as spacers that will also be glued in place. For the 2 biggest circles that goes on the side of the engine block, I was cutting out 4 circles out of EVA and they will be glued together with a strip of EVA as you can see here. This circle is just a long strip that I glued on the end together, and it will be formed the inner circle of the engine pieces that goes on the bigger ones, and it will get an additional strip of EVA for more detail. And this will be glued right there. I made an additional piece just like the first one, just a little bit smaller, that will be glued right there. On the outer piece I just added on the inside and outside these small EVA pieces for more detail, and I also added some rivets. Also I added a smaller circle piece on the other smaller circle piece that I made before. Now I'm just adding two stripes of EVA on the inner circle. So this is what it looks like after cutting the box smaller after my mistake for making it too big, and I also glued the two detailed parts wrong on and I had to fix this later. I had cut out a lot of strips out of EVA and they will be glued on the gears, and for this I use a piece of EVA itself as a spacer. This step will be repeated 4 times on each gear, and on 2 of each gears there will be facing in a 45 degrees angle. These two pieces are scored in the middle and treated with a heat gun so they look like a big bolt, and they will be glued in the middle of the gear. An additional layer of EVA is added on each side for more detail. I still haven't fixed the issue with the details part because they are still facing the wrong way, but I will swap them later. And on the pieces that I just glued on, I will attach the gears. The handle is glued in place and I will use these L brackets for more stability. This piece will be glued to the handle and it will be covered later in EVA that will go to the bottom. I had cut two of these pieces out and they will be glued on the left and right side together, and they will go over the piece that I just glued on before. Here I just fixed the issue that I had with these two detailed parts that were facing the wrong way. Now I'm just gluing the cylinder onto the main engine. I made this piece out of EVA, two big bolts, two eyelets, and also I added two stripes around the cylinder for more detail. I'm using the eyelets because the cable will fit right in there. And sadly here I lost a lot of footage. Big sorry from my side, but I just added a few of bits, pieces, scribblies all around the engine and the handle. So it looks a little bit more interesting, and yeah, I try to show it in the video so that you can see what goes where, and yeah, and also I plasti dip the piece. The weirdly big shape on the other side of the engine is just a cut out piece that I had lying around. It matched the original and it got a hammered look with the Dremel. These are all the eyelets that I added for the cables. Now I started painting, and for this I used the Tamiya gunmetal. In between the gears I just brushed the small strip in a bronze color. These two pieces on the grip will also get this bronze color. The bolts and the eyelets will be painted in a chrome silver. We'll be right back. For the last step of painting before the weathering, I use rubbing buffs and I will attach this all over the hammer. For the weathering, I just used black acrylic that I sent down with water. The black paint will be wiped away with some tissue paper. On the handle itself, I just glue some bandages on that will be spaced apart, and for this I just use normal super glue. For the last step, I just glue the cables on in this order. With that, the hammer is done and it's time for some beauty shots. So this was a tutorial. I know it's not good, but it's okay in my opinion. This was the first of two videos. The second one will be about the whole costume itself, hat, coat, all the small details and everything that he wears. If you have any questions, just let me know in the comments down below. Subscribe to this channel, give it a like, share it with your friends. And until then, see you next time and have a good day.